नमस्कार, हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल हॉस्पिटलिटी विद मी। आई एम सागर, हॉस्पिटलिटी ट्रेनर, कोच, बार स्मार्ट सर्टिफाइड, एंड इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू हाउ टू सेट अप योर ओन मिनी बार एट योर ओन पर्सनल स्पेस एट वेरी अफोर्डेबल प्राइसेस एंड विद लिटिल बिट ऑफ प्रोफेशनल टच। सो स्टे ट्यून्ड इन दिस चैनल। सो बाय द एंड ऑफ इट आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू, आई विल गिव यू सम ऑफ द टिप्स ऑफ द बार टेंडिंग। So friends, I have been working in the hospitality industry for a while. I have worked with the professional bar and star hotels in India, abroad, and I always get this question from my friends that how they can have a professional bar experience at their own personal space where they can entertain themselves and occasionally their guest as well. Now these are the tools which are required for your bar. I'll give you the name, use and the price. So let's start with the first. These two tins are together called a Boston shaker, which you can put it like this. You can have a nice shake and then you can offer it to the customer. I would recommend you to use this. In fact, there are other shakers as well, which are three-piece cocktail shaker. In fact, Japanese shaker is also available. Just like that, this is a Japanese jigger, also called as a peg measure, which is most important in the bar. This is our bar blade, which is required to open your beer bottle. And with this, you can remove the screw cap, the plastic screw cap of the bottle. This is my favorite. I got a trident here, like Aquaman. All right, fun apart. This is used for mixing the drink or stirring the beverage nicely. You can taste it as well. This is the muddler. In case if you are using the mint leaves, you can muddle it. Have a nice flavor in your cocktail. Ice tong and ice bucket as well. This is the hot throw strainer. You'll be needing it. Put it in the cocktail shaker and you may serve your drink so that no ice particles or lemon seeds will be getting into your cocktail and you'll have a fine cocktail with you. This is a lime squeezer. Along with that, you have another bottle opener which comes handy. I have pair of knife for cutting up the fruits and for garnish as well. Here I have a speed pourer which you required for your bottles. Once you remove your optic pourer, you might want to put this. So with this you are going to get a nice flow. Just like that, I have plenty of other which are quite affordable. Now here comes the price. This cost 100 rupees, Boston shaker 300 rupees, jigger 140 rupees, speed pourer is for 45 rupees, tong for 50 rupees, bar blade 100 rupees. These are the coasters which comes as a set, so 120 rupees. Muddler again for 50 rupees, then bar spoon 140 rupees, and then we'll move towards these three equipments, these small tools which I haven't told you earlier. Reason being that they are quite specialized for the wine. In case if you are a wine lover or you are serving wine to your guests, you might want to go for this. So here I have the pourer along with the stopper, so you'll have no trouble while pouring the wine. This is the most important one, the corkscrew. With this you can open the wine cork. Also with this a beer bottle can be opened. Now this ring, you must be wondering what is it for. This is not for this. In fact, this is for removing the foil of the wine bottle. So you do not want to use the knife. You might want to go for this. This is quite good. So this is what the tool what we have. Now we'll move towards the glassware. That's the next segment. Well, these are the set of glasses which I have it in my bar. So I'll give you a brief introduction about each and every glass which you should have in your bar. So here in first segment, I have, these are the rock glasses, also known as old fashioned glass. These are used for serving whiskey on the rocks, even neat as well. Here I have one more old fashioned. You can just go for two cubes of ice, two to three cubes of ice, and nice your whiskey. In fact, people like to go for vodka also on the rocks. Here I have some more old fashioned glass. In fact, in this you will get a smaller size also, which can be used for serving shots. If you are not serving whiskey or anything, you may go for your aerated beverages, Pepsi, Thumbs Up, Coca-Cola, if your guest is not having alcohol. This I would say you must have it in your bar. This is the martini glass. You may serve gin martini, vodka martini in this. In fact, it's a Bond's drink. Here I have highball glass. This is used for serving your mixed drink, gin and tonic, along with lot of ice. In fact, you can have your screwdriver in this. Here I have the tall boys. These are called as a Pilsner glass. This is used for serving Pilsner beer. You may also serve Long Island iced tea in this. Here I have the handle, so you can use it for serving beer. You will definitely appreciate your beer in this. These are the segments of wine. Now you have a sparkling wine or champagne. These are definitely the glasses what you should have. White wine glass, and this is my favorite, brandy balloon or brandy snifter. This is how you can have it. But these glasses only you must have when you have your wine selection in your bar. If you do not have wine, then there is no need to have this glassware. In fact, this you can use for serving any cocktail or mocktail also. Here I have the mason jar. This is an oversized mason jar. You may get for 200 ml as well, and that looks nice. In fact, you can serve mini shots of mojito also into that. This is a home edition for mojitos. Also, you can serve your milkshake in this particular glass. So these are the various glassware which I have. So you can also think which one is suitable for your bar, and you can definitely purchase that. So guys, till now we have discussed about the glassware which are required and tools which are mandatory for a bar. Now we'll look into the bar cabinet, how exactly it should be. Now if you can see, I have converted this old bookshelf into a bar cabinet. In case if you don't have the bar cabinet, nothing to worry. You can pick up a right spot, pick up a plain wall, apply a nice wallpaper, have three glass shelf, and you can have nice glasses on that along with a good choice of liquor, whatever you like. You don't need to keep so much of liquor, as we are not running a professional bar. You can have something what you like. And in fact, there is a limitation also of liquor what you can keep it at home. In my next video, I'll cover that. What liquor you can keep if you require to have a big party, do you require to have a license or no? In next video, we can cover up that point. Which liquor you should have in your bar is strictly based on your taste, budget and availability of the spirits at your home. But I would recommend you to go for few of the white spirit and few of the dark spirit. White spirit, I mean vodka, white rum and gin. Whereas dark spirit, you can have whiskey, dark rum. In whiskeys also, you can have Indian, Irish, American, Canadian, depending on your choice. Well, in case if you want to know how to use each and every one of this equipment and how to make fantastic cocktail, please leave a comment. So accordingly, I'll make one video for you where I can teach you the methods of cocktail, parts of cocktail, garnish, how to serve that cocktail to your guest. If you have any preferences, please write that in the comment box so I can include that in my next video. And on the last note, I would like to say you'll have to be responsible bartender, responsible host for your party, because you are dealing with liquor and you are dealing with your human life. So I would say responsible bartending. Please follow that. Thanks for watching Hospitality with me, Sagar. I hope this would be helpful for you. So guys, enjoy your time and stay in touch. Take care. Bye.